tool
which was used in the Paleolithic age. Now, apart from this Paleolithic age, the second thing that came out was, if I do the comparative study between Paleolithic age, Mesolithic age and Neolithic age, so it is Paleolithic age, Mesolithic age and Neolithic age. Neolithic age is the latest age, Mesolithic age is the middle one and Paleolithic age is the oldest one. So first thing that was habitational structure. Habitational structure was, we were hunters, nomads. Second thing, in the Mesolithic age, we started to settle down. We discovered some kind of potholes, we discovered some kind of, you can say, architectural remains. So we started to live, or we started to build our own homes. So every habitational structure was, here it was nomads, wanderers and food gatherers. But here it was somewhat fixed settlement. Here it was fixed settlement. कहीं ना कहीं ये fix होना शुरू हो गए थे in the Neolithic and Mesolithic ages. Second thing could be, you can differentiate it on the points of tools and implements. Tools and implements. If I talk about this tools and implements, during Paleolithic age, the tools and implements were of single stone, as we talked earlier. Whereas in the Mesolithic age and the Neolithic age, in the case of Mesolithic age, the tools and implements were of composite in nature. Composite tools. Now, what are these composite tools? If this is a tool, then this tool will be on the head of a bone, and it will be tied on the bone, so it will act as another weapon. So there is a slight, you can say, slight transformation of a weapon from a single tool to multiple or a composite tools. Whereas in the Neolithic age, this again changed. From Paleolithic age to Mesolithic age to Neolithic age. Neolithic age comprised of this kind of a tool, plus we also had one more important tool, that was the missile tools. Now, what are these missile tools? These missile tools, dear, are nothing but arrows, bows, arrows. All these things included in the Neolithic age. So, it was a development from the Paleolithic age to composite tools to missile tools. So we shifted ourselves from these parts to these parts to these parts. After that, what happened? Paleolithic age, Mesolithic age, Neolithic age. In the Paleolithic age, what happened? As I discussed with you friends, that in the Paleolithic age, ice age was the last one. So ice started melting. Ice, barf. Barf pigalne lagi. अब जब बर्फ पिघलने लगी, उसके साथ व्हाट हैपेंड, इट गेव वे टू रिवर्स. नाउ इट गेव वे टू रिवर्स. व्हाट हैपेंड इन द केस ऑफ रिवर्स, रिवर्स बहना शुरू हुई. अब जब रिवर्स बहना शुरू हुई, तो कहीं ना कहीं एक ऑप्शन आ गई, दैट वी नीड नॉट टू मूव टू द अदर प्लेसेस इन सर्च ऑफ फूड एंड वाटर. व्हाई? बिकॉज दीज रिवर्स देमसेल्व्स ब्रॉट अलोंग विद देम फिश एंड अदर फूड मटेरियल्स. Other animals used to come over here in these rivers, and they used to have water. So it is something like, we need to concentrate over here around the rivers. हमें यहाँ पे rivers के आसपास रहना पड़ना था. अगर हम इन rivers के आसपास रहते, तो हमारी सारी needs पूरी हो जाती. So in the Mesolithic age and Neolithic age, if I am saying that habitational structure was somewhat fixed. Now why it was somewhat fixed? It was fixed because rivers started flowing. अगर रिवर्स फ्लो करना शुरू कर गई, तो उस कंटेक्स्ट में क्या होता है, उस कंटेक्स्ट में ये रुकना, हैबिटेशनल स्ट्रक्चर आपका फिक्स हो गया. सो इन मेसोलिथिक एज फिक्स स्ट्रक्चर वाज देयर, इट फर्दर एम्प्लीफाइड इन द नियोलिथिक एज. So what happened? Earlier we were used to be nomads. Nomads से हम settle होना शुरू हुए और settle होने के बाद हम उसको further उसको amplify करते गए in the Neolithic age. So habitational structure was in this sense. Third part in this we can include about social behavior of these people. Now what is this social behavior? Social behavior. In these we were animals. In Mesolithic we were somewhat skilled animals, but in the Neolithic and Chalcolithic age there was a difference. Now what was the difference? In Neolithic and Chalcolithic age hame kuch cheezein aur mili, like double burial. Double burial, one thing. Second thing was ankle cut. Ankle cut. And third thing, double burial, ankle cut. And third thing that we came along with, we discovered was grave goods. Hame ye cheez ek aur mili. क्या? डबल बरियल, एंकल कट, ग्रेव गुड्स. मतलब अर्लियर वी वर टोटली नोमैड्स, हमें नहीं पता था कि हम कहां घूम रहे हैं. वेयर सो वी फाइंड फूड वी विल जस्ट रन ओवर देयर एंड डू हंटिंग एंड फिल आवर स्टमक्स. आफ्टर दैट वी स्टार्टेड सेटलिंग समवेयर. आफ्टर दैट जब हम सेटल हो गए, जब हम एक जगह रुकना शुरू कर गए, आफ्टर दैट वी रियलाइज कि हमें कुछ और चीजें भी चाहिए. हमें डबल बरियल मिला. So according to historians, what is this double burial? Double burial is something where two bodies were buried together. And according to them, what does it mean? It means that there was a concept of being together after death. So might be a chance that double burial would lead or would mean marriages. Because as such we don't have any kind of written proof over here in the Paleolithic, Mesolithic and Neolithic age. So we have only archaeological remains. These are archaeological remains, habitational structures and all. So in these archaeological remains, double burial will lead to the concept of marriage. Ankle cut. Society banti gayi. As society grew, interaction between the people started, and when the interaction between people started, they also found one more thing that was very important, that was the ankle were cut of the people during the burial. So this would lead to the, you can say, historians took it in the way that during that time people practiced one thing, that is jadu tona totka, spells and charms. And finally we have grave goods. Grave goods bhi hame mile. Grave goods is something like mummies. Hum mummies ki baat karte hain jo ki Egypt ki hain. In those mummies, what was the case? That if a king or a queen died, then they used to put gold over there and they used to put other food items along with that king or queen. Why? Because they thought after the life it would be required by these people to in their way ahead. So in that context, if we look towards India, we also find some kind of grave goods. In today's world, we still find some kind of grave goods concept. So grave goods was there. So it was a concept of Atma, spirit. So it was something like Stone Age, Paleolithic Age, Mesolithic Age, Neolithic Age, prehistoric, and that has to be bifurcated further as a habitational structure. In habitational structure, Bhimbetka caves, important. Tools and implement is important. Social behavior is important. Their pottery and warehouse is important. So this was something related to the Stone Age. We shall be continuing on to this Metal Age in the Chalcolithic Age and Megalithic Age in future lecture series. Thank you, class. Thank you, friends. Thank you very much.